This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, it is Wednesday. So, of course, Chef George is here from Portsmouth Public House. And today you brought us breakfast.
Breakfast. Scones.
What are we making? Scones.
Not just any scone. Rum raisin scones.
Yum. This day got a whole lot better. Mm-hmm. Okay, so a couple ingredients on the counter there and probably things that we already have lying in our pantry.
It's the easiest thing in the world to make. I mean, scones are so simple. Mm-hmm. It's really simple. It's flour, butter, some baking powder, sugar, a little bit of salt. We have milk, eggs, and vanilla.
Okay, I have some questions now regarding these ingredients. Milk,
yes.
Whole, skim.
I use whole milk when I bake.
Okay.
The rule of thumb.
Is it okay to use something like a skim milk, or is it going to mess with the texture?
It messes with the texture.
Okay.
It's too watery. It would be like if you're that conscious about fat, just use water. Don't use the milk at all.
You know,
and just use. Just moisten it, or use powdered milk. You know, get a fat-free powdered milk and swap it out with the water ratio.
Okay, so a couple different options there: butter, salted or unsalted.
I eat regular salted butter.
Okay, keeping it simple there.
Yep.
And you said, all right, these are rum raisins.
Rum raisins.
This is the really only prep that you need to do is you need to let them soak.
8 hours.
Okay.
Yep. Overnight. You want to keep them on the counter. You don't want to put them in the refrigerator.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to over-soak them, because what happens is if you over-soak the raisin, it's going
to
swell. Yeah, exactly. It goes back to the grape
really
state.
Does that really
happen? No, it will.
Oh,
it'll just swell right up. And when you bake it at that totally swollen state, all of the liquid comes out of it, and it ruins your recipe.
It ruins the scones.
It makes it too doughy
and
sunny.
So 8 hours. That's it. We are going to get these scones started. I'm so excited. In just a bit. Back to you.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen today. Chef George is here. Portsmouth Public House, one of our favorite places. They are our Wednesday regular. They're here with us today. And, man, they are cooking up a storm today. We got rum raisin scones. And this guy just opened up the oven. And I was like, wow. So wait till you see what the finished product is going to look like. They are amazing. But we're going to get cooking right now.
Yeah, so really simple. What I did is I added all of the dry ingredients into the flour mixture.
Right.
And then what we're going to do is we're going to add all of this into the mixer.
Into the mixer.
So if you could just dump that into the mixer.
Right in here.
Yep.
Into this KitchenAid. Some stuff is going on.
That's all right.
Dump this in here.
Yep. And then what we're going to do, Will, is we're going to add the butter to that as well.
Okay. I think we got a fog in here from the flour. So put that in. Okay.
All right. And then just take all of the butter and just dump that in there as well. And then what we want to do is we want to put it on the mixer speed super low. And when you start this, what you want to do is you want to kind of pulse it.
Yep.
A little bit.
Just to get everything kind of like matted down.
Set it down. Yep.
And then just let it go like this.
And just let it go for about a minute or two until all of that butter incorporates into the flour, your baking powder, and so forth.
Okay.
And then when that's all incorporated, it's gonna look like thick coarse salt.
Right.
You know?
Yep.
And then when that's incorporated, we're gonna add the rum soaked raisins in.
Make sure
the liquid is drained out of this before you add it into
So drain it in. So soak the raisins put the raisins in there with the rum.
Mm-hmm.
Drain it out, let them sit, and then you're able to dump it in there.
Yep, dump it in there. And then what I did is I added the milk, the eggs, and the vanilla into this. Scrambled it up a little bit.
So when this is done, then we'll put all this in there.
Yep,
and that'll kind of smooth everything out.
One, two, three.
Boom, boom, boom. All right, good
Perfect.
Stuff. And like I said, wait till you see the finished product that this guy has made this morning. You're going to wind up making this afternoon. We are going to show you that in just a little bit. Back to you. Here in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, Portsmouth Public House is here. Chef George is here, our Wednesday regular, and he has rum raisin scones. Lots
Yum.
Of oohs and ahs when you opened up that oven.
It smells amazing. So what I did is when the mixer, I just added the wet ingredients.
Right.
It forms a ball.
Mm-hmm.
I put it on the rolling board. Right, and then I made another ball with my hands to knead it all in and make sure everything was incorporated.
Okay.
And then, Will, what we want to do is we just want it very gently. Just you want to roll it out, so it's like about an inch to a half inch thick. You know, just and do that,
and just keep rolling it here.
Yeah, just nice and gentle.
Is this a dough that needs to rest? You can work with it right away.
It's a little right about there. That's perfect.
Good.
Actually, that's absolutely perfect. And then what we want to do, Will, is I want you to cut it in half like this.
Yep.
And then half again, and then each in blocks.
Okay.
And then while he's doing
like
that, Michaela, if this is just confectioner sugar and just a little bit of water to make an icing.
Oh my gosh!
You know, and that's
it. It's gonna get drizzled over our scones.
And Will, I'm just gonna sneak in here. Sorry,
that's okay.
Tight quarters in the kitchen. And then while you're doing that, I'm gonna pull this tray out that we have in the oven.
As I go.
All right, and
put that right there.
Okay, so once they are put on the tray, on the pan, you line it with parchment paper, which I'm sure is important. That way they don't stick burn.
Yeah, well, a good little trick is sometimes, commercially, we get our parchment paper flat. Mm-hmm. Lots of times people buy parchment paper and it's in a roll, and everyone always tells me, how do you get the parchment paper to stick?
Yeah.
What do you put underneath?
Take a little bit of Pam spray.
And put that underneath.
Spray it, you put it down.
Acts like glue.
And there we go. And then, wow, these are, do you want a job?
Yeah.
These are perfect.
This thing doesn't work out. Maybe you want.
I don't know. My wife better watch out because she usually makes these every day. But those look amazing.
Let's make sure they.
Yeah, okay. Fine. And then you just want to line it on the tray like this because they're not going to expand much, as you see. They're almost the exact same size.
Okay, you know, that's what I was wondering too, because when I was looking at even just how thick they were. I was wondering if these were going to, how big they were going to actually expand.
A scone, what it does is a scone goes up.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, and that's it. And that's how you know really when it's done is it has this nice little break in the center like that.
Right.
It's super light. You tap it, it's hollow on the inside,
and
everything's 100%.
So when we bake these, time and temp?
350 for 20, 25 minutes until it's golden brown.
Got it.
And then we're just going to take these, pop them in the oven. Pop those in the oven. And if you have a convection setting on your oven, that's the way you want to do it, is with convect bake.
Got it.
And then, Michaela, if you just want to drizzle these.
Oh, you got
it. And then we'll grab a plate, and you guys can dig in.
Okay.
Here we go. I'm going to drizzle it with this.
Oh, man, look at this.
I feel like I just need a spoon. This is not enough icing.
This is not a boating accident. Put that in.
There we go. And I'll just grab this right here.
That looks good.
Like that. Okay. All right, now, Will, it's right out of the oven, so it's going to be hot. So you might want to break it in half.
So take a huge bite.
And is there anything else that you like to put on this?
No,
just as is.
I'm just going to put that like that, Michaela.
That's fine. Yeah, I'm going to keep going with this icing.
And you can use, instead of using the rum-soaked raisins, you can use dry fruit. We use Reggie makes every single day at the shop.
Reggie's your wife.
House. Reggie's my wife and our baker. She makes blood orange and pineapple scones.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
Reggie, can you bring those next time?
Yeah, and then and then she also came up with a gluten-free recipe for scones as well.
Oh, that's good, too.
Delicious.
No flour. Yeah.
And this is something, too. I know we're saying they're rum raisins. Did you have to soak them in a light rum or a dark rum, or does it matter?
I actually soak this is the big fight in the kitchen. So I like spiced rum.
Okay.
And somebody else likes like it's a cream rum. Mm-hmm.
Do you want to name that someone?
So either,
no, I don't want to mention my wife because she'll yell at me some more.
Either one will work. Right?
Either one will work fine. The most important thing is drain the liquid. Whenever you're soaking anything to reconstitute it from the dry state, you want to really drain the liquid.
Got it. That way it doesn't ruin
all right.
any of it.
So just break this open.
Oh, my gosh.
And, man, it just breaks right apart. Soft inside. You can see how it is inside.
And whenever you're cooking or baking with alcohol,
it always burns off.
Man, George, I'm telling you.
This is fine for the kids,
You
too.
Did it again because these are so good.
Right?
So good.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
So good. Oh, my God. We're just saying
I'm just taking a second.
Just bear with us here for one time.
I know today was St. Joseph's Day, and I probably should have made Zabelis, but this is.
We have those represented as well. We have those, and we have scones, and you can make them for yourself by heading on over to WPRI.com for the recipe.